Catching you up now on more news of the day. A 911 call warning of a home invasion, a shooting, and a possible hostage situation sparked a SWAT team response and kept neighbors indoors. And tonight, Dixon Police say it was a hoax. KCRA3 first broke that story of a prank caller tricking police.
Now, Dixon Police warning other law enforcement agencies to be aware of pranksters playing a game with 911. KCRA3's Mike DeSalle's been on the story all day. He has the latest on what appears to be an emerging trend.
There it is. There's the medical helicopter lifting off. From the medical helicopter lifting off to SWAT officers swarming in, Dixon residents describe what happened this morning on Carpenter Court this way.
Not your normal morning here in Carpenter Court.
It's kind of crazy for small town Dixon.
Around 4 a.m., police say a caller who claimed to be hiding in a closet inside this home called 911 to say that two men had broken into the home, shot a woman in the neck, and were now ransacking this home. SWAT teams raced in. They told neighbors stay indoors. Only problem was this.
It turns out this was a hoax call that came in from outside the residence. There was no incident inside the residence here.
In fact, Dixon's police chief told KCRA3 what happened here to entice a police response may be part of an emerging trend they had just been warned about in the past week.
But I understand that there has been information put out to law enforcement warning about false calls coming in to generate a SWAT response. And so this is just an example of that we need to be very discerning about information that comes in, but we have to take calls seriously.
Adding a level of concern to all of this, the fact that it all happened a block away from an elementary school. Police say they are right now investigating to determine who is behind this, and if caught, they say that person is going to face some serious criminal charges. In Dixon, Mike Tissell, KCRA3 reports.
Dixon police have said they have not said what it cost to do all of that this morning with the SWAT response. However, they did say roughly 24 people from multiple agencies responded to the 911 call.